Hi everyone, in this video I will tell and show you how using Cascadeur and Blender you can make a beautiful animation for your character. But first we need a character's model of course to work with. This video is not about how to create models, so you won't see anything except time-lapse here of some fragments that were recorded during the creation of the model, so if you are not interested in, you can skip this part. But anyway, I'll add in description the links to helpful videos from cool authors that I used to watch a lot when I was learning how it works. So if you don't know how to find it, you can find helpful videos for you in the description. And no, this is not an advertisement, this is a goodwill gesture. When our model is ready to work, we need to transfer our character mesh to a website called as mixamo.com. That will allow us to quickly create a skeleton without any problems, but after that we will need to finalize the downloaded model, because with a very high probability the weights on the mesh assigned to the bones will be arranged exactly as we would like them to be. The logic behind these actions is that Mixamo helps us to create a base in the form of skeleton animation that we can improve and then apply to Cascadeur. In order to start editing your model, you must download your character in T-pose stand along with the mesh. So if you downloaded different animation and decided to edit the skeleton and weights on it, I have a bad news for you. For such adjustments, it is enough just to put the bones that were created in Mixamo in necessary places according to the idea, and a little finalization or remake the weights. This is needed to make the model bend only the way we want it to bend, not the way the Mixamo algorithm did. Although in most cases Mixamo does the weights quite well. The main thing to consider is that you shouldn't change the names of the bones, and editing the entire skeleton should be on the downloaded character model, which stands in T-pose as well. Also, while editing the skeleton, you should always check all weights by simply manipulating the skeleton. By this I mean simply rotating the bones just to make sure and that the weights are edited correctly and you haven't made any mistakes. Nothing complicated here. If you don't really want to delve into animation in Cascadeur, you already can do a simple export of the edited model back to Mixamo and download the animations without skin and apply them to your character. But the video is still about using Cascadeur in conjunction with Blender, so we're moving on. But before that, we can download our model from Mixamo again and just make sure everything is working as it should. And so, now we're in the Cascadeur, and first of all, we will import our edited character to the scene to start animating him. To do this, we must import our model into the program scene, and then Cascadeur will ask us if we want to create a rig. Click yes, and then click on the Add Rig Elements button, because the skeleton from Mixamo is perfectly recognized in this program. Very quick instruction, put to remove animation keys is F. Enable smoothing for animation between the frames is Alt plus B. Play animation is XK, but it's very strange and I did this action on Shift and Space, which I suggest you do the same thing. This video will not be a full-fledged tutorial on how to animate, for my main idea of the video is that I want to show how to easily use Blender and Cascadeur together without breaking the animation and without using tools like retargeting. Anyway, I think that if you're watching this video, you're at least on some level familiar with this program and you will learn something new from this short tutorial. Let's say you've made an animation, what do you do next? Then you need to bind your skeleton to the physical animation, which is what Cascadeur is famous for. Only then we can get a beautiful animation in Blender. After this action, we must export our model as a scene, because it's very important. Otherwise, the skeleton will be broken and you will have to deal with retargeting and AK bones. When I add an animation from Cascadeur to Blender, I just can hide the skeleton, then removing the model attached to it. And then, in the action editor, I'm typing a normal name for this action. After that, the skeleton that we just added, you can safely delete because the animation itself will be saved in Blend file. But to ensure that it will not disappear after starting Blender or your computer, click on the icon similar to the shield. This will prevent the animation from being deleted as a temporary cache. Then I just change the main character's animation in his skeleton to the one we added. And magic, everything works. I hope this video helped you. Thank you all for watching. Also, please support my videos, although it's rarely published, but still, it's motivating. I'll say bye to you right now, but the video continues as you will see what this all about, or in different words, the final result, right after one more time lapse. See you!